The Boston Public Health Commission is in a campaign to encourage more healthy nutrition with help from farmers markets. To tell us what's happening are the Commission's project manager for the campaign, Maura Ackerman, and the manager for the farmers market in Egleston Square, Scott Farrell-Forstein. Thank you both very much for being with us.
Thank you.
I want to talk about with Maura first here, because I guess one of the most important messages is that this is something that's not only good, but affordable.
Absolutely. So farmers markets throughout Boston are an affordable point for locally grown produce, and that's really important to us. With Mayor Walsh's Boston Bounty Bucks program, customers who receive SNAP, which is the new name for food stamps, so it's the Supplemental Nutrition Assistance Program, receive a dollar-for-dollar match up to $10 on their farmers market produce purchase.
Scott, you're in the business world here, so you've got to compete against other places, and maybe you're going to offer something that they don't quite match you on. So what can people find at Egleston Square?
So it's a friendly competition, but each farmer obviously is bringing something different. So they all have these things that they specialize, whether it's a variety of garlic or an assortment of plums, you know. So each market is going to have a different farm there. So then we get a lot of customers that actually sway from market to market because of that reason, actually. And I think each market at this point probably has like over 2 to 3 farms. So there's a variety that you get by going to them, whereas you would get that same variety at a grocery store.
And the campaign really tried to highlight the variety of produce. So we have 8 different models, all Boston residents, showcasing 8 different products that are available at Boston Farmers Markets at comparable prices to what you might find in a supermarket. So we really focused on those seasonal produce items that are available July and August, you know, these heat of the summer months that are these bountiful products. So radishes, collard greens, corn, all of these lovely products that you can find at farmers markets.
And Scott, of course, different markets are in different neighborhoods. You got different populations. So, Egleston Square area, still have a lot of a Latino population. You got the hipsters.
Of course, yeah.
So I guess you got to have things that they like.
So exactly. It's funny because it is a border. We're literally on the line of Jamaica Plain and Egleston. So we get the JP section. We get people from Brookline, even people from Roslindale and from Egleston. So there is that huge Latino community. And there actually is a Ethiopian community as well there that has been there for a while. So it's interesting to see like people standing next to each other and then vibing on the same fruit. It's pretty fun.
This is BNN News. We're talking with Maura Ackerman of the Boston Public Health Commission and Scott Farrell-Forstein of the Egleston Square Farmers Market. Maura, what about the importance of local produce? Because you can walk into a lot of chain supermarkets and you see these nice produce sections. Visually, they're very appealing, but I guess a lot of this is how it tastes once you start eating it.
Absolutely. And what we're really trying to do at Boston Public Health Commission, obviously we care about health, so we're trying to increase people's consumption of fruits and vegetables to prevent chronic diseases and to prevent obesity. And the best way to do that is help people to love fruits and vegetables, which is all about taste, quality, and the longevity in your fridge. So when you're thinking about products that were grown and picked within 24 to 48 hours, that's really going to last a much longer time than things that have been sitting on the grocery store shelf and on trucks coming from thousands of miles away for a really long time. So we know that people just get to enjoy that produce for a longer period of time, get to taste the full flavor of locally grown produce, which is a totally different product often than what you can buy in a grocery store.
Scott, what about the need to get a little education about how to prepare food too, because a lot of these people you buy the raw ingredients and then but again you got to ask some shopper next to you what you do with it, right?
Yeah. So actually, last year we came across that specifically with mushrooms. So we had a vendor that specialized in mushrooms, and there's certain mushrooms that you have to cook. It's like very necessary, actually, and that's one thing that I actually love vendors for is they know their product, they know what knowledge needs to be shared, and a lot of them do that, whereas we also do demos at markets, and that also helps very much. So whether it's taste or the way that something should be prepared, you know, especially with fish, and our fish vendor actually can teach a person how to like debone and descale, and so we put a lot of weight on them, and I think we take some of that weight as well.
Maura, I know some people are pressed for time to cook food, if not money, but on the other hand, if you compare that with eating out, especially if it's fast food, the health effects are pretty serious.
Absolutely, both in terms of cost and in terms of health. The food that you can buy outside the home is so high in fat and in particular sodium, which is very hidden from people. And so we really try to stress how when you cook it for yourself, you cook at home, you can use all these flavorful herbs and spices and reduce the things that you don't want to eat and really let the flavor of the vegetables sing for you.
Right. By the way, Maura, I guess there's some other things in the mix here too, an Instagram contest.
Yes, so the campaign, which is actually bilingual, so we have two hashtags. We have the hashtag in English, Farm Fresh Boss, and then the Spanish hashtag is Fresco de la Finca, Boss, excuse me. And so both of those hashtags on Instagram and Twitter will be doing a weekly drawing for farmers market swag that winners can post either. They can post their farmers market purchases or they can post the beautiful food that they cook with those purchases. So it's a fun way of having people engage over social media across the neighborhoods of Boston about the produce that they're bringing home.
Scott, one of the things you do with the market in near Egleston Square is you try to capitalize on the location because you're close mm-hmm. to the old brewery complex.
Yep.
Really.
Yep. Yep. So we're right there at the brewery, and at about 9 a.m., so our market opens at 10. There's a line of about 70 people already lining up.
We should make sure people, which day of the week is this now?
Saturdays, 10 to 2, every Saturday from, we already started in May, till February. And we'll be in that same area. Actually, we go indoors to a place called Urbano Project, which is another nonprofit that we highly support. So,
and of course, one of the advantages that you get at least a few parking spaces, maybe sometimes, and there are other things going on there. So people,
you
go to the market and do something else right after, and still be in the same area.
Yeah, there's children's groups, actually, like programs specific for like dancing or drop your child off here and go. Do what you need to do.
Plus, and there's a certain cafe that I think a lot of people.
Yeah, Lula's right down there too. And we close off the street, so there's a bit more safety than we had originally gone into because we were using a parking lot there. But there's a trolley that they would come through. So now that we close off the street, we can bring in more vendors and have people more comfortable, and it's a good feeling.
And Maura, Chris, are there a lot of people who probably have these markets in their own neighborhood and they might not know about it? So how do you check this out and get a list of things, maybe?
Absolutely. That really stresses the point of the whole campaign, which is Farm Fresh is right around the corner. So there's over 25 markets in almost every neighborhood of Boston open. There's somewhere you can purchase with bounty bucks every day of the week. And so people can find the markets closest to them, their workplaces, the schools where they attend, their homes, at boston.gov/farmers markets.
Great. Well, thank you both very much, Maura Ackerman and Scott Farrell-Forstein.